Bonjour tout le monde et bienvenue sur Irvin's French Class. Aujourd'hui, dans cette vidéo, nous allons parler du pronom en. After the pronoun i in the previous video, we are now covering another important and very much used pronoun, the pronoun en. After reviewing its functions and uses in context, we will do together some fun activities to revise and practice. C'est parti. The pronoun en often corresponds to the English pronouns some and any, and even none in negative sentences. But in some cases, it could also be translated by a preposition of, from, or about, and there, it, or even a stressed pronoun. For example, from there, about him, of them. The pronoun en replaces direct objects introduced by articles du, de la, de, and l apostrophe, and then a vowel, of course, de, and the negative de. It will then be translated as some, any, or none. For example, tu fais du sport? So if we want to answer that question and avoid the repetition of du sport, we're going to answer oui, j'en fais. And we use en to replace du sport. And du sport, here is the direct object. Tu fais quoi? Du sport. And it is introduced by the article du. That's why we need to use en. Similarly, est-ce qu'il mange de la viande? Non, il n'en mange pas. Est-ce que j'achète des croissants? Oui, achète-en. Est-ce que tu as de l'argent? Non, je n'en ai pas. Est-ce qu'elle a bu de l'eau? Oui, elle en a bu. The pronoun en is also used to replace a place or a thing, not people, introduced by the preposition de, translated as of, from, or about in English. For example, est-ce que tu viens de France? Oui, j'en viens. So here we use the en pronoun to replace de France, the origin. Okay, here it's a place introduced by the preposition de. Second example. Est-ce que vous aimez parler de vos voyages? Oui, nous aimons en parler. And here again, we use the en pronoun to replace de vos voyages, which is a thing introduced by de. So as you can see in our examples, the pronoun en usually comes before the verb. That includes its use with il y a, il y en a, il n'y en a pas in the negative. And en is here included in the negation. Like for in the example, non, il n'en mange pas. So the en pronoun really sticks to the verb right in front of it, included even in the negation. In an infinitive construction, en comes before the infinitive. Like in our example, oui, nous aimons en parler. In the imperative affirmative, en comes after the verb and is linked to it by an hyphen, tiré en français. That's in writing and the liaison in speaking. For example, prenez-en with the the sound. Bois-en again with the sound for the liaison. As we've seen for the e pronoun, the s of the to form needs to be put back for the liaison to occur. Achète-en. In the imperative negative, en comes before the verb. For example, prenez-en, that's positive, n'en prenez pas, négative. Achète-en, négative, n'en achète pas. And here you need to remove the S again. There is always liaison after en when the next word begins with a vowel. Je n'en ai pas, je vais en acheter. So normally, je n'en ai pas, je vais en acheter. While some, any, and none can be omitted in English, en must always be used and expressed in French. In the passé composé, there is no agreement of the past participle with en. although I remind you, on is the COD and it's placed before the verb. Est-ce que tu as pris des vacances? Oui, j'en ai pris. So here the COD is vacances. Est-ce que tu as pris quoi? Des vacances. But that COD is introduced by des. That's why we need to use en. But be careful. If we avoid the use of des, like here, est-ce que tu as pris tes vacances? In that case, we are not going to use en because the COD is not introduced by des, but we are going to use the COD pronoun that we have seen in a previous video. So in the answer, oui, je les ai prises. And because of that COD pronoun, you need to make the liaison here. E, S at the past participle. Vacances is feminine and plural. All right, now let's do an activity to revise and practice. All you need to do is to answer these yes or no questions, either positively or negatively, reusing the verb of the questions. Numéro 1. Est-ce que tu joues du piano? So we're going to answer positively. Oui. Oui. So you need to use the en pronoun because piano is the direct object introduced by du. Oui. Jean, très bien. J apostrophe en. Jean joue. Oui, Jean joue. Numéro 2. Est-ce qu'il mange du gluten? Non. Il n'en, N apostrophe en, il n'en mange pas. Très bien. Est-ce qu'il y a du sucre dans les crêpes? Oui. So that was the expression il y a. You need to put en in front of the verb, which is a. Oui, il y en a. Oui, il y en a. Numéro 4. Est-ce qu'elle va prendre des photos? You need to answer negatively. So here we have an infinitive construction. Okay, that's the near future. Est-ce qu'elle va prendre des photos? So en here comes right in front of the infinitive. That's right. So non, elle ne va pas en prendre. Très bien. So the en sticks to the infinitive. Numéro 5. Est-ce qu'il a vu des films français? Oui. Il. So with the passé composé, it's right in front of the verb, well, the auxiliary. Oui. Il en a vu. OK. Numéro 6. Est-ce que j'achète du beurre? So here we are looking for the imperative. Oui. So buy some. OK. Achète. Zan, très bien. You need to put that S for the liaison, ok? Achète-en. Voilà les amis, c'est tout pour cette vidéo. J'espère que vous en avez apprécié plusieurs sur ma chaîne. So that's one use of the en pronoun. N'oubliez pas d'ajouter un pouce bleu et de vous abonner. Au revoir, à plus. Ciao!